Hi, welcome back to my channel. This is Dr. Uchenna. In this video, I'm going to be talking about mindset and beliefs for growth and success. The growth mindset, basically. But what is mindset? Your mindset really is a set of beliefs or assumptions about the possibilities of your life. And about what is possible for you and what is not possible for you to do in life. So that's what we call mindset. Mindset has been your mindset, our mindset, my own mindset, you know, is it's a paradigm that has been cultivated over time, over a very long period of time. For you and I, it has started from birth. Nature has giving us, you know, some certain qualities, and yet there's what we call nurture, which means that we can we have the ability to expand on what we have been given already. So what we know, you know, about mindset is that it's malleable, it is adjustable, it is flexible, it's plastic, in the sense that you can shape it into any form that you want. You can redesign it. You can rewire it. That's what it is. That's what the science tells us, and that's what we know from experience. So there's nothing fixed about the mindset. So, now there are two different types of mindsets. Yeah, that's what it takes me to know. There's the fixed mindset, and there's the growth mindset. The fixed mindset assumes that we already have traits or qualities, you know, that cannot be altered or changed, and therefore we can only work within the limits of what we have. Then the growth mindset is a belief system, you know, that it's not just a belief system; it's a different philosophy, you know, and scientific evidence facts too. That through learning and through deliberate practice, we can change our beliefs about life and our assumptions about what is possible for us. Yes, so there's a popular quote from Henry Ford, you know, that goes like this: whether you think you can or you think you can't, you're right. So if you believe that you can change or you don't believe you can change, either way, you're correct, because your beliefs are going to determine the quality of your life. Your beliefs are what are the foundations of your mindset and how you go about doing things in this life. So what beliefs do you have? Is these beliefs that we really need to challenge? And the only way to change, the only way to know these beliefs, you know, is to reflect on them. To think about them, to take a critical look at our lives and at the process that has brought us here. Have we given up? Do we believe that we have reached our limits? Is there anything that we can do to get better? I believe we can get better. The science tells us that we can get better. My life tells me that I can do so many things that that seem impossible. I came out from a life of addiction and failures and mistakes and regrets and grief and, you know, so many things. To come out now and do my master's and postgraduate certificate and PhD, finish all successfully with flying colors. But it took a lot of grit, a lot of hard work, a lot of consistency, a lot of deliberate effort to be the best. And of course, believing, first of all, that I was going to do it. Because that was the foundation of everything. I came with the belief, with the mindset that I can do, I will be the best at what I'm doing. And so far, so good. I've been given certificates or whatever that show that that I can actually get the best results possible. And now I need to move it further. That's why I'm talking to you here. That's why I make these videos every day to improve on myself and, you know, to fix some parts of my life that that I've had issues with in the past. So it takes deliberate practice in the end, and this is the part that's not easy, because you need to leave your comfort zone. The fixed mindset is what keeps us in our comfort zone. And by being there in that zone, we accept mediocrity. We just accept life as it is. Nothing wrong with that, you know, if that's the kind of life you want to live. Everything depends on what you want to do with your life in the end, what you want to achieve, what you believe that you're here to do. So if you have the mindset that you're just here, you know, that you have been disadvantaged, you cannot, or you don't have any ambition, you know, to be anything more than someone that came here, maybe had a family, paid the bills, and, you know, died, then that's okay. But if you want to do something, if you want to do something better for yourself, whatever it is, if you have a dream or whatever that you want to achieve, then you need to embrace this growth mindset. You need to be deliberate about it by practicing. And when I say deliberate practice, I'm an example to you, because if you look at the videos I've been doing, maybe for the past 1 month, I've been doing it every day and every day. That's what I call deliberate practice. I will need to get better, I know. I will need to structure it a bit better, I know. I might need to do some editing and whatever and all the other things, I know. I don't have the resources and everything I need for now and the time, and, you know, it's not that organized as it is now, but I'm working towards that type of organization. I'm working towards making it better. But for now, I'm trying to just improve the skills that I have. So it's not comfortable for me. It's not comfortable to be doing this all the time. But I have this desire, this urge to do it. So I'm doing it. So back to the deliberate practice, you know, nothing gets better. If you want to get better at anything, you have to practice consistently at it. Let's say, for example, I'm trying to write a book, my second book, and I've been stuck somehow, you know, I've been stuck again in a way, because I have something I've already written down, and it's difficult when you don't have like a blank page, and I'm trying to remove and add, and it just seems a bit difficult for me, but I'm working on my mindset, you know, that will make it seem a little bit more possible for me. And every day I'm trying something, I'm trying to do something to move it forward. So you have to leave your comfort zone, like I said earlier. And being outside your comfort zone is risky, it's difficult. So you need to do difficult things, because you're no longer protected by the elements that you are comfortable with. So you're outside your comfort zone. You're doing something that's challenging you. You're doing something that demands emotional risk. You're doing something that has an inherent risk of failure and of criticism and all that. But if we don't go there, then we're not going to get better. And it's just a simple example can just be, you know, exercising or whatever. If you have to keep fit, if you have to keep fit, you know you have to do something that's not so comfortable every day for you to get in shape. Or if you want to lose weight or something, you know you have to change your food, change your diet. You know that your mindset or whatever, you already have a particular inclination or your likeness for a particular kind of taste of food. So for you to move from all those fried and whatever food, sugars and whatever, to start eating salads and vegetables, you know, it's a process, a gradual process. But gradually you can do it. People have done it, and so many people are still doing it even today as we speak. So yeah, that's what the mindset is all about. It's really ingrained beliefs, you know, it's in the subconscious mind. In future videos, you know, I'll be explaining more about how to move this mindset, how to change this mindset. But you need to remember, it's based on a core belief about who you are and about what you can do in life, which you can change, which you can challenge every single time every single time it comes to your awareness, you know, that that you're behaving in a negative or limiting way, and usually it comes to us every day. You know, when you're trying to do something difficult, there's always that resistance. So we need to fight against it. We need to fight against the resistance. By fighting, I don't mean a violent kind of fight. It's more of like an embracing of the, just is acknowledging through mindfulness, through awareness, you know when those thoughts come up because they are thoughts, and you're able to catch those thoughts when they come and just turn it, gently reverse it, so that it faces the other way and you can now deal with the mindset, but knowing that you have a vision. I promise you that I'll do a video about how to create a life purpose statement or a life vision statement, and I will still do that. I'm coming to it, but I have to keep doing these videos while I'm working on that. Yes, so thank you for listening to me, and I'll see you guys on the next video.